It looks like it's 10 in favor and 6 counting the verbal no opposed. Kim?
So the motion is passed.
The state Sexual Offender Management Board voted to adopt language to replace the term sexual offender. The board put forth 6 options for replacement terminology, but ultimately settled on the first choice, adult who commits sexual offenses. The language is a tricky subject. There were objections and concerns raised over whether the term should be past tense or present tense.
This language is, in the committees that I've been on, seems to be the most supported of these options, not proposing that there's not others that they would have chosen, but by victim professionals, as it highlights the active reason someone is in treatment and doesn't assume that the behavior is over.
Some folks weighing in saying they'd like offenders to be referred to simply as clients when receiving treatment.
The use of the word patient to refer to someone receiving health care, and in this sense, client would make the most sense to track these principles, referring to someone receiving the kind of treatment that SOMB providers deliver.
But for survivors like Kimberly Corbin, they say offenders need to remember the crime they committed even after they've been reformed.
I'm well familiar with the labeling theory. I actually agree with most of it, and it's very, very damaging for those people who are labeled when it has to do with gender, race, sexuality, ability, but those aren't their choices. The biggest thing to me is that this is a choice that sex offenders make.
Gabrielle Franklin, Fox 31.